In this video, I'm going to show you how to create high-quality feedback forms in Zoom using the new advanced poll features. Let's dive right into it. If you don't know how the advanced poll feature works, make sure to check out my earlier video. Link is in the description. When you are in a Toastmaster meeting that is conducted online, one of the challenges is to get audience feedback for your speakers. What if we could launch a feedback form like this? Wouldn't that be amazing? Let me show you how to do it. Start by going to your Zoom account and schedule a new meeting. Click on Meetings, Schedule a meeting, and enter the details of your meeting. Choose the date, time, and the duration, and click on the Save button. Scroll down till you find this option, Polls and Quizzes, and click on the Create button. You should be presented with two options, Polls and Advanced Polls and Quizzing. If you don't get this, go back to my previous video. Click on Advanced Polls and Quizzing. Start by giving a title to your poll. Let's call it Feedback for Speaker Number 1. For the first question, we could ask the audience to rate the overall performance of the speaker. For such type of questions, the right choice is what we call a rating scale, which is here. Frame your question accordingly. How would you rate the overall performance of the speech? And we will ask the audience to rate it from 0 to 10. We can change the labels to represent the low scores and the high scores. Rather than using negative terms, let's use Toastmaster terms. So a low score would represent developing, and a high score would mean exemplary. Let's make it a mandatory option. One of the cool things we can do with advanced polls is to add images. Click on the three buttons and select Upload Image. Navigate to the folder that has the images. In this case, let's say I want to choose an image of our speaker. And there we have our first question. For our second question, I want to evaluate the speaker on different speaking criteria as defined by Toastmasters, such as clarity, vocal variety, eye contact, and so forth. Let me copy the same criteria in my feedback form. I will choose the question type as rank order and phrase the question. How would you rate the speaker on the following criteria? Let me enter all the criteria on the left-hand side, starting with clarity, vocal variety, eye contact, gestures, audience awareness. Click on Add Row to add more rows. Let me add comfort level, and finally, interest. For the columns, let's use the same terminology as Toastmasters. 1 means developing, 2 emerging, 3 accomplished, 4 excels, and 5 exemplary. Let's make that also as a required field. We can also create text boxes where audience can enter their feedback as free text. Let's create 2 text boxes, one to highlight things that the speaker has done really well, and one to indicate some areas of improvement. Click on Add Question, choose Long Answer from this list, and phrase your question. For example, what did the speaker do really well? You can change the length of the text box from 200 to a higher number, let's say 500. We will keep this field optional. If the audience wants to enter something, they will. If they don't want, they can leave it blank. Add one more question. This will also be a long answer. Let's phrase the question. For example, what are areas of improvement for the speaker? Let's also keep it to 500 characters. That should be enough. Also, not mandatory. Let's leave it optional. That completes the feedback form for the speaker. Click on the Save button. If you have more than one speaker for the meeting, it's very easy to duplicate the poll. Click on these three buttons and select Duplicate Poll. Now we have two polls. All I have to do is change the name of the speaker and the photo. Click on the Edit button. Change the title of the poll. And click here and upload the relevant photo of that speaker. And your second feedback form is done. Click Save. If you have more than two speakers, do the same thing. Click on the three dots duplicate the poll and change the name of the poll and the photo. Of course, you don't want to do this process for every meeting as it can be time consuming, but there is a solution for that too. Scroll up and save this meeting as a template. Click on Save as Template, give a name for your template and Save as Template. The next time you want to create a meeting with all of these feedback forms ready-made, all you have to do is, when you schedule a meeting, click on Meetings, choose Meeting Templates and select this template that you have just created. And when you use this template, all of the feedback forms will be already there. All you have to do is go and change the speaker name and their photo. The last part is how to share this feedback with the speakers. That's very easy. Once the meeting is over, come to your Zoom account and head over to Account Management and choose Reports. Select the option Meeting, and there is an option here called Poll Report. Choose the date of your meeting and click on the search button. And once you identify your meeting, you can click on the Generate button. This will generate an Excel file for you, which you can click on the Download button here. And this will create a CSV file that you can easily open in Excel. The Excel file contains everything that was captured in the feedback forms. All you have to do is copy and email that feedback to the speakers. And that, my friends, is how you can get amazing quality feedback for your speakers in your next Zoom meeting. Give it a try.